A beautiful morning to you, my brothers and sisters, and welcome to another glorious edition of Rhapsody of Realities. Today is Thursday the 23rd, and our title for today is Subject Your Plans and Desires to Him. Our opening scripture is from the book of Romans chapter 12 verse 1, and I read, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that ye present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. Hallelujah! Oftentimes, people have desires that are not in sync with God's plan. They don't care about God's will. As a result, they do whatever they choose, hoping somehow God would accept their actions. They try to force their will on Him, but it doesn't work that way. Ask, why are you taking these actions? And they would tell you, I prayed about it. As far as they are concerned, God ought to accept their actions and choices since they prayed about it. That's absurd. There is a difference between doing something because you prayed about it and doing something because God said so and that is His will for you. The latter is the best and safest place to be, fulfilling God's purpose for your life. Never find yourself doing things for which you think you do not need God's approval. That a plan, an idea, or desire has been in your heart all your life doesn't mean it came from God. There are people who are born with demons right from birth. Some others receive demons while growing in an environment that's littered with evil, wickedness, and demonic manifestation. It is one of the reasons some people grow up with morbid desires that stay with them for many years and finally they act on them. But now that you are born again, hallelujah, God expects you to present your body to Him as a living sacrifice. Also, your mind must be yielded to His word. Your heart must be regulated by the word. This is the reason for meditation. Meditating on the word guards your thoughts in the things of God, in the direction of His plans and purpose for your life. Do not act on carnal desires of the mind that are inspired by the world and its system. Stay focused on the word. Hallelujah. Wherever you are right now, kindly raise your hand and take this confession right after me. My spirit, soul, and body are filled with God. I give vent only to His thoughts, ideas, and desires. He is at work in me, both to will and to do of His good pleasure. My life is the expression of His will and glory. Hallelujah! Glory be to God. Now, I highly suggest that you take some time today to study these following scriptures. From the book of Romans chapter 12 verses 1 to 2 and the book of Proverbs chapter 3 verse 5, preferably the Amplified Classic Version. Hallelujah! So what do we do next? Share this beautiful message to as many people as you know. Glory be to God. Tune in again tomorrow for another explosive message. You are blessed. We trust you have been blessed by this devotional. We invite you to make Jesus Christ the Lord of your life by praying thus. O Lord God, I believe with all my heart in Jesus Christ, Son of the living God. I believe He died for me, and God raised Him from the dead. I believe He is alive today. I confess with my mouth that Jesus Christ is the Lord of my life from this day. Through Him and in His name, I have eternal life. I'm born again. Thank you, Lord, for saving my soul. I am now a child of God. Hallelujah! Congratulations! You are now a child of God. To receive more information on how you can grow as a Christian, please get in touch with us by emailing us at tni.msia@gmail.com. That's tni.msia@gmail.com. We look forward to hearing your testimony. You are blessed.